Hello everyone, I'm Subhojit Panda from OdishaTV.in presenting you today's news from Odisha. First, the headlines. Ruckus in Odisha Assembly over RD Women University issue. Speaker asks Treasury Bench to reply over the issue in the afternoon session. Special team of Sundargarh Police leaves for Haryana to bring back the minor rape victim. BJP Mahila Morcha, Congress and Aam Aadmi Party stage mass protest. Demand Odisha as alcohol-free state. Absorption of medicos of Sardar Raja's college gains momentum after filing of miss case in Odisha High Court. And Rajya Sabha MPs move privilege and contempt of the upper house notice against BJD MP Baijan Panda. Now the details. The State Assembly has witnessed repeated adjournments following pandemonium by the opposition Congress over the confinement of students of Ramadevi University during Chief Minister Naveen Patnaik's visit to the varsity on Thursday. Following the ruckus, the Speaker Niranjan Pujari first adjourned the House till 11:30 a.m. Later, he adjourned the House till 12:30 p.m. and further till 3 p.m. The Speaker also asked Treasury Bench to reply over the issue during the afternoon session of the House. Earlier on Friday, the House was also adjourned till 3 p.m. amid a ruckus created by Congress MLAs for same reason. As soon as the House assembled after an adjournment till noon, Leader of Opposition Narsingh Mishra demanded an apology from the Chief Minister on the issue. When the proceedings began in the House earlier in the day, Congress MLAs stood on their seats and shouted slogans demanding a reply from the state government. Later, Congress Chief Whip Tara Prasad Bahinipati and other party MLAs stormed into the well of House while sloganeering. Bahinipati climbed onto the Speaker's podium and tried to break the mic. Legislators of other opposition parties also joined the Congress MLAs and shouted slogans. Unable to run the House, Speaker Niranjan Pujari adjourned the Assembly till noon. Notably, nearly 20 students of Ramadevi Women's University were detained on the campus on the suspicion that they might create trouble during the Chief Minister's visit to the varsity to attend a function on occasion of its first inaugural day yesterday. A special team of Sundargarh police left for Haryana to bring back a 12-year-old girl of Sundargarh who was allegedly sold and later raped in Uttar Pradesh some 4 months ago. Police sources said they have received an official communication regarding this from their Haryana counterpart to investigate the matter. Reports published in national media said the girl was first brought to Uttar Pradesh by a local youth on the assurance of job 4 months ago and was later sold for Rs. 50,000. After being abused, she managed to escape and made it to Palwal in Haryana, about 50 km from Gurgaon, where two men raped her again. The child was later rescued on 30th November after a villager in Palwal spotted her lying in the field and took her to the local women's police station. The police have arrested the two persons who allegedly raped her and left her in the field and are on the lookout for her uncle and persons who bought her, said sources. According to the child's complaint lodged at Palwal Women's Police Station, her uncle brought her to the village in Mathura, Uttar Pradesh, 4 months ago. Later, he expressed his desire to marry her, and when she declined, he sold her to people he knew for Rs. 50,000, she stated in her complaint. The men who bought her sexually assaulted her for days, she told the police. According to the girl's complaint, she somehow managed to escape and reach the bus stand in Palwal. While she was waiting for a bus, two persons came in an auto rickshaw and forcibly pushed her into the vehicle, took her to a field and raped her, she stated. Acting on her complaint, in a joint rescue operation with Shakti Vahini, a child helpline NGO, Palwal police arrested two persons on charges of kidnapping and raping the child, said sources. BJP Mahila Morcha, Chhatra Congress and women's wings of Odisha Congress on Friday resorted to road blockade outside Ramadevi University and burned effigy of Chief Minister Naveen Patnaik protesting against the alleged confinement of the girl students. Both Congress and BJP demanded apology from Chief Minister while BJD defended the government saying that the girls were not in uniform. The girls were tortured mentally. The Chief Minister needs to apologize for the confinement incident, Leader of Opposition Narsingh Mishra said. BJD MLA and Government Deputy Chief Whip Rohit Pujari said the girls were detained as they were not in proper dress code prescribed by the university. As far as my knowledge is concerned, police detained them as they were not in uniform. On the other hand, officer on special duty OSD of the institute, Padmaja Mishra, said the complainants have not presented their version, though they have been asked to depose before disciplinary committee. Meanwhile, the state assembly also witnessed pandemonium, with the opposition demanding the Chief Minister Naveen Patnaik should take responsibility for alleged detention of some students. Sources said nearly 20 students of Ramadevi Women's University were detained on the campus on Thursday on the suspicion that they might attack Chief Minister Naveen Patnaik, even as he and Higher Education Minister Pradeep Panigrahi were delivering speeches during the celebrations of the varsity's first inaugural day. The students were released after the Chief Minister and other dignitaries left the university campus.
Ramadevi University Jiyomanku असम्मानित करा जाइछि, निर्यातना दिया जाइछि, मानसिक जंत्रणा दिया जाइछि, अतएव सेति पई से गृहरे क्षमा भिक्षा करिवार एकांत आवश्यकता अछि। आमे दाबी करिछु मुख्यमंत्री गृह को आसी क्षमा भिक्षा करंतु।
पशुपरी छात्री मानंकु रमादेवी कॉलेज रे गोटिए जाली तार जाली घर भितरे बंद करी देकी बाहरु ताला दियागला। मान्यवर मुख्यमंत्रींकर उपस्थिति रे जो ऑफिसर मान अछि तांकु प्रथमे दृढ़ कार्यानुष्ठान ग्रहण करा जाउ, एवं एथिपई मान्यवर मुख्यमंत्री ओडिसा विधानसभा रे क्षमा प्रार्थना करंतु।
Apparently taking a cue from Bihar Chief Minister Nitish Kumar's recent statement to make the eastern state a dry one, a mass protest demanding liquor ban in Orissa was organized by the supporters of BJP Mahila Morcha, Congress and Aam Aadmi Party in Bhubaneswar on Friday. The protest rally, which was taken out from Master Canteen Square here, also got support from activities of Orissa Nisa Nibarana Abhijan, Milita Mahasangha in Daringbadi and Sachetan Nagarika in Kandhamal. The slogan shouting protesters holding placards demanded implementation of Bihar and Orissa Excise Act 1956 to minimize liquor-related deaths in the state. When the Nitish Kumar government has decided to ban liquor in his state, why it can't be possible in Orissa? Asked a protester. The Orissa government should have learnt a lesson from the Hooch tragedy in 2012, which claimed 43 lives in the state, he said. However, rubbishing such a demonstration, Excise Minister Damodar Raut in his usual sarcastic way shared total prohibition is unrealistic. Sale and consumption of alcohol is banned in Gujarat, Manipur and Nagaland, as well as the Union Territory of Lakshadweep. Besides, Kerala government has also planned to ban liquor in a phased manner. All other Indian states permit alcohol consumption but fix a legal drinking age. Reports say alcohol consumption in India has risen over 55% over a period of 20 years despite all the restrictions in place.
ସବୁବେଳେ ଆଖି ଆଗରେ ରଖନ୍ତୁ, ନିଶା ନିବାରଣ କେମିତି ସମ୍ଭବ ହୋଇପାରିବ ଚେଷ୍ଟା କରନ୍ତୁ। ସେଇଥିପାଇଁ ମୋର ମତ ହେଉଛି ଆମେ ନିଶା ନିବାରଣ କଥା ଅବାସ୍ତବ ଜଣାପଡ଼ୁଛି, ତେବେ ସେଭଳି ନିଷ୍ପତ୍ତି ତ ମୁଁ ନେବା ଲୋକ ନୁହଁ। ସରକାର ଯଦି ମୁଖ୍ୟମନ୍ତ୍ରୀଙ୍କ ନେତୃତ୍ୱରେ ଯେମିତି ନୀତିଶ କୁମାର କହିଛି କହିପାରନ୍ତି, କିନ୍ତୁ ମୋର ବ୍ୟକ୍ତିଗତ ଅନୁଭବ ହେଉଛି ଆମେ ସମ୍ପୂର୍ଣ୍ଣ ନିଶା ନିବାରଣ କଥା ଚିନ୍ତା ନକରି ମଦ ସମ୍ପ୍ରସାରଣ ଯେଉଁଭଳି ଘଟୁଛି ତାକୁ ନ କରାଇଦେବା ପାଇଁ ନିୟନ୍ତ୍ରଣ କରିବା ଉଚିତ ହେବ।
The controversy over reallotment of Sardar Raja's medical college students in three government institutions is gaining momentum with each passing day, with the filing of miss case in Orissa High Court on Friday. In the petition, the medicos of Maharaja Krishna Chandra Gajapati MKCJ Medical College Barampur, Veer Surendra Sai Medical College and Hospital Burla and SCB Medical College and Hospital Cuttack have urged a stay on the High Court's 12th November ruling. In the order, the court had asked the Orissa government to shift and accommodate 124 students of Jaring-based medical college in three state-run institutions. The intervening petition, which was filed by the students on the issue prior to today's miss case, will be heard on 9th December. Health services in all the three medical colleges have hit due to the agitation of students who have been opposing the High Court order, citing lack of infrastructure and faculties in the respective institutions. Members from at least six opposition parties on Friday moved a notice alleging breach of privilege and contempt of Rajya Sabha against Lok Sabha MP of BJD, Bijan Jay Panda, for his write-up calling for reducing the power of the upper house. In the notice to chairman of the upper house, Hamid Ansari, Rajya Sabha MPs Mohsina Kidwai from Congress, KC Tyagi from JDU, Naresh Agrawal from Samajwadi Party, T.K. Rangarajan from CPIM, D. Raja from CPI and Derek O'Brien from Trinamool Congress held that the views expressed by Panda constitute breach of privilege and contempt of the House. They took strong objection to Panda's write-ups in some newspapers in which he said the reforms must reduce Rajya Sabha's power to block the popular mandate and favouring a rethink on veto power of Rajya Sabha. The members said if any individual or authority violates or disregards any of the privileges, powers and immunities of House, he may be punished for breach of privilege and contempt of the House. The sources said.
हमने कहा है कि श्री पंडा के आर्टिकल से राज्यसभा के की मान मर्यादा कम हुई है और उनके वक्तव्य से जो इसकी शक्तियां हैं संविधान में प्रदत्त हुई उसका उल्लंघन हुआ है, लिहाजा ऐसे आपत्तिजनक लेख के लिए उनके विरुद्ध जो है ये प्रिविलेज मूव एक्सेप्ट किया जाना चाहिए और कार्रवाई की जाए।
ये जो नोटिस आनी मो विरुद्ध है সেটা হচ্ছে গোটে আর্টিকল মু লিখিছিল এবং সে আর্টিকল উপরে সে বোধহয় আর্টিকলটা পড়িছেন কি না জানি হেডলাইন পড়ি বহু লোক কমেন্ট করে দিকে মু তাহলে লিখিছিল যে যেভাবে অন্য লোকতন্ত্র মানে খাস করি ইংল্যান্ড আমেরিকা এবং ইটালি তাঁকর সাংসদরে পরিবর্তন আনিছেন যাদ্বারা কি দুই গৃহ ভিতরে এই প্রকার তুতু মেমে হয়েকি পুরা সবু অটকি ন যায় ତାଙ୍କୁ ଆମେ ଦେଖିବା କଥା ଏବଂ ତା ଉପରେ ଆଲୋଚନା ହେବା ଉଚିତ ଆମ ଦେଶରେ।
ସତ୍ୟମ ଶେଖର ରାଓଲ, ଦ ଆଡପ୍ଟେଡ୍ ସନ୍ ଅଫ୍ କଣ୍ଟ୍ରୋଭର୍ସିଆଲ ଗଡମେନ୍ ସନ୍ତୋଷ ରାଓଲ ଆଲିଆସ ସାର୍ଥୀ ବାବା ୱାଜ୍ ରିଲିଜ୍ ଫ୍ରମ୍ ଚୌଦ୍ୱାର ଜେଲ୍ ଅନ୍ ଫ୍ରାଇଡେ ଇଭିନିଙ୍ଗ ଆଜ୍ ପର୍ ଦ କଣ୍ଡିସନ୍ସ ଇମ୍ପୋଜ୍ଡ ବାଇ ଦ ଓଡ଼ିଶା ହାଇକୋର୍ଟ ୱାଇଲ୍ ଗ୍ରାଣ୍ଟିଂ ବେଲ୍ ୟେଷ୍ଟର୍ଡେ। ସତ୍ୟମ ଫର୍ନିଶ୍ଡ ଟୁ ପର୍ସନାଲ ବେଲ୍ ବଣ୍ଡ୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ରୁପିଜ୍ 50,000 ଇଚ୍। Hearing the bail plea, the single judge bench of Justice C.R. Das had also ordered that Satyam cannot leave the state without permission of the crime branch. He would have to appear before the investigating officer once in a fortnight. Satyam, who was in custody after being arrested from Mumbai in August, had filed the application for bail pleading innocence. Seeking bail for Satyam, his counsel had argued that the youth had no known source of income and all the valuables and properties used by him belonged to his father. Moreover, Satyam has cooperated with the police and since the police have not sought any further remand, he should be granted bail. Satyam's lawyer argued, on the contrary, the crime branch had charged Satyam with cheating, forgery and misappropriation of huge amount of money from the people in the name of God. The crime branch counsel said Satyam had purchased a flat in Bhubaneswar for rupees 1.15 crore, but the sale deed mentioned only rupees 55 lakh. This undervaluation has caused loss to the state exchequer. The counsellor said, the accused deserves punishment for receiving stolen properties and having a bank balance of rupees 25 lakh, the crime branch argued. An inter-ministerial team from the centre on Friday visited the drought-affected areas at Bhavanipatna, Narla and Kesinga blocks in Odisha's Kalahandi district. The four-member central team led by K.S. Srinivasan, Joint Secretary to the Department of Agriculture and Cooperation, interacted with farmers and villagers to take stock of the extent of the crisis. Later, Srinivasan, the team leader, expressed concern over the widespread damages to crops, including paddy, due to the drought. On Thursday evening, the team held meetings with the collector and district-level officials. The drought triggered mostly by monsoon failure has affected 1,642 villages spread over 234 gram panchayats out of a total 2,248 villages in Kalahandi district according to an assessment by the State Agriculture Department. The Agriculture Department assessment revealed that 49,304 hectares of paddy land and 21,743 hectares of non-paddy land had been adversely affected due to erratic monsoon and moisture stress condition. Panic gripped for some time in the Sri Jagannath temple premises of Odisha's Puri as a fire broke out all of a sudden near the Ma Bimala temple in the wee hours of Saturday. Sources said the fire spread in the Sarala house of the Bimala temple at around 5 a.m. and after being informed, fire brigade officials rushed to the spot on time and doused the blaze. The mishap occurred after fire broke out from wood and coal stored inside the house, while no damage to life or property has been reported. The Sarala house is near a kitchen room inside the temple. Odisha has provided rupees 5 crore in assistance to flood-ravaged Tamil Nadu, Parliamentary Affairs Minister Bikram Arukh said on Friday. Speaking in the Odisha Assembly, Arukh said the government has provided the amount from the Chief Minister's Relief Fund. Chief Minister Naveen Patnaik had on Wednesday spoken with his Tamil Nadu counterpart J. Jayalalitha and assured all support for relief and rescue operations in the wake of the floods. All Odias stranded in Tamil Nadu are safe. Sources in the office of the Special Relief Commissioner said over 1 lakh people from Odisha stay in Chennai. More than 100 Congress, BJP leaders and workers of Gopalpur Assembly constituency on Friday joined Biju Janata Dal BJD. They all joined the ruling party after meeting BJD Supremo and Chief Minister Naveen Patnaik at Naveen Nivas in Bhubaneswar in the presence of Higher Education Minister Pradeep Panigrahi. Reports said a group of about 100 dissident Congress and BJP workers, including sarpanch of Narayanpur, Indrakhi and Ganju Gram Panchayat, members of Kanisi Gram Panchayat and Naib sarpanch of Indrakhi and Narayanpur Gram Panchayat joined the ruling BJD. Speaking on Congress and BJP members joining BJD, Chief Minister Naveen Patnaik said, a number of members from Congress party from Gopalpur in Ganjam district have joined the Biju Janata Dal. Pradeep Patra, Manorama Sahu and Bala Reddy have joined BJD along with their followers.
A number of members of the Congress party from Gopalpur in Ganjam district have joined the Biju Janata Dal. Shri Pradeep Patra, Sarpanch, Srimati Manorama Sahu, Sarpanch and Shri Bala Reddy, ex-Sarpanch, they've joined with their followers.
Before wrapping up the news headlines once again. Ruckus in Odisha Assembly over RD Women University issue. Speaker asks Treasury Bench to reply over the issue in the afternoon session. Special team of Sundargarh Police leaves for Haryana to bring back the minor rape victim. BJP Mahila Morcha, Congress and Aam Aadmi Party stage mass protest. Demand Odisha as alcohol-free state. Absorption of medicos of Sardar Raja's college gains momentum after filing of miss case in Odisha High Court. And Rajya Sabha MPs move privilege and contempt of the upper house notice against BJD MP Baijan Panda. That's all for today. Thanks for watching.